Presented by ChargebackGurus.com.
How omnichannel merchants can avoid payment fraud. In this hyper-connected digital world we're living in, customers can come to you from any direction, and smart merchants are learning how to meet their customers where they're at, no matter where that might be. The name for this approach of marketing and selling across multiple platforms is the omnichannel, because it encompasses every possible vector through which merchants might engage their customers. Unfortunately, any conduit for customers will also bring fraudsters, and the omnichannel can present them with multiple opportunities and vulnerabilities to exploit. How can merchants safely take advantage of omnichannel marketing without exposing themselves to excessive fraud and chargebacks? The omnichannel isn't one thing. Like its name implies, it includes every method of shopping available to customers: mobile, web, in-person, phone, social media, you name it. Instead of focusing on a few specific channels, the omnichannel approach emphasizes putting content out on as many of them as possible, and integrating the various systems underpinning them so that customers can have a seamless and consistent experience across all channels. The danger here is that without sufficient resources, you can end up with a scattershot approach that spreads your content too thin, and worse, leaves you open to fraud at multiple weak points that you aren't able to monitor and protect effectively. A dependable omnichannel strategy needs to anticipate these hazards and set the right defenses in place. What types of fraud come through the omnichannel? Omnichannel fraud isn't really different from the existing forms of fraud that merchants experience. After all, the omnichannel isn't anything new and separate in and of itself. It's just a term for working multiple existing channels together. However, merchants can get caught off guard when they venture into new and unfamiliar channels, and there are ways for fraudsters to leverage multiple channels to increase the likelihood that their schemes will pay off. Here are some kinds of fraud that can be especially pernicious in the context of the omnichannel. Card testing fraud. Stolen payment credentials are cheap and plentiful on the illicit markets of the dark web, but fraudsters can tell by looking at them if they're still valid or if the cardholder has already cancelled the account. The way they find out which credentials are still usable is making small, easily overlooked purchases. If these transactions are accepted, they know they can try to use the credit for a bigger purchase. Omnichannel merchants may unwittingly offer up multiple points of sale that can be used for quick, low-scrutiny card testing. Cross-channel fraud. One issue with the omnichannel is that a compromised account on one channel can create vulnerabilities in other channels. BOPUS, Buy Online, Pick Up at Store fraud, is one common example of this, as it enables fraudsters to make purchases with stolen cards and then immediately pick up the item without having to wait for delivery and hope that the cardholder doesn't realize what happened and cancel the shipment. There is also the risk that user accounts linked across multiple channels allow hackers to pick and choose the most vulnerable point to attack. And once they've broken into account on one channel, they've gained access to all of them. Mobile fraud. This year, as much as 45% of all e-commerce shopping in the United States will have been transacted on mobile devices. Consumers love shopping on their smartphones and tablets, but the apps they're using aren't always as robustly secure on desktop websites. Many apps grant significant unchecked spending privileges to any users who can get past the initial login screen. Return fraud. A common and decidedly low-tech form of fraud is to order a product, use or strip it for parts, and then return it for a full refund. Fraudsters can make a purchase on one channel and initiate a return on a different one to bypass some of the screening procedures that would otherwise detect their scheme. How can merchants protect themselves from omni-channel fraud? No merchant can ever be 100% safe from fraud, but adequate planning and preparation can do wonders to reduce the harm it can do to your revenue and your reputation. Here are some of the essential measures for reducing omni-channel fraud. Anti-fraud tools. There's a lot of software out there designed to detect and block fraudulent transactions. And while these always carry some risk of filtering out valid customers, they can be a huge help to merchants dealing with a high volume of fraud. The most sophisticated programs use machine learning and artificial intelligence to recognize fraud indicators and flag transactions accordingly. Multi-factor authentication. Download the e-guide, 4 Reasons to Hire a Chargeback Management Company. The vast majority of fraudsters prefer to take advantage of quick, easy opportunities. So, something as simple as 2-factor or more authentication can easily thwart most of them. This can be deployed at checkout with programs like 3D Secure. But merchants may also wish to utilize a form of multi-factor authentication when the user first logs into their account on the app or website. Cross-channel tracking. One of the biggest mistakes a merchant can make is to look at instances of fraud in isolation and not attempt to connect them across channels. For example, a perpetrator of return fraud might be banned from your brick-and-mortar store but still has an account on your e-commerce store. By tracking fraud across all channels, you can blacklist fraudsters from the entire omni-channel once they're discovered. Conclusion. True fraud leads inevitably to chargebacks, and merchants have no basis to fight valid fraud-related chargebacks through representment. The only opportunity you have to fight them is before they've succeeded in getting away with a purchase. With a well-considered strategy and the right tools, you can market your wares across a vast expanse of the omni-channel without worrying that you're going to be overwhelmed with true fraud chargebacks. If you're not sure where to begin or what tools to use, remember that an experienced and qualified chargeback management firm will always take the time to help you build up your fraud defenses too, as a preventative measure against future disputes.
To learn more, visit chargebackgurus.com.